Tell me about your life here in prison. Do you read newspapers? Do you listen to the radio? Do you watch television? Do you communicate with people on the outside? What goes on for Charles Manson in this prison?
Well, I can feel the grass growing out there on the lawn, and there's a few trees that's got some leaves on it that I can feel. And I've been in jail all my life, so I'm actually right here at home. How long have I been in jail? 34 years? 34 years, so...
Out of 47, you've been here 34.
I've been in jail, prison, a long time, all my life. I was raised up in here. So I understand jail, so I understand myself, and I can deal with that. I set my cell, and I do my number, like a convict does his number.
You like jail, don't you?
I don't dislike or like.
Let's go back to 1967, the time you were winding up serving a term of number of years, 10 years. And written accounts indicate that you told the authorities, "Don't let me out. I can't cope with the outside world." Do you have a recollection of that?
And you make a desperate plea out of something, man. There's no desperate plea out of it. I say, I can't handle the maniacs outside, let me back in.
I didn't use the word desperate. That's your word, Charles.
Yeah, well, your inflection and your voice tones were implications there.
Well, you use the word maniacs on the outside. How are you different from the maniacs on the outside? And why do you call them maniacs? Because you know something, they think you are one.
Yeah, it would reflect. If you hold the negative up to the light, you don't see the light, you just see the negative. So I'm a reflection of your negative, there's no doubt about that, and I can handle that also. I've been handling, ain't I?
I don't know, have you?
Well, I've been up and down these damn hallways, in and out of these nut wards for the last 10 years. You think you could follow that act?
Don't want to follow that act.
Yeah,
I don't want to get into it. But why do you want to get into that?
Well, what crowd? What crowd are you playing for?
Huh?
I'm playing for my life. You working for money.
What does that mean, you're playing for your life?
I'm working for my life, mister. I'm not playing for money.
What do you mean you're working
for keeps?
What do you mean you're working for your life?
I'm playing for real.
What does that mean, you're playing for real? How are you playing for your life?
That's something you can't buy.
When you say you're playing for your life, am I to assume that you think that someday you're going to get out of here?
Get out of here. Get out of here. Where would I go now? See.
What would you do if you got out of here?
I got out of here.
What if they said to you tomorrow morning, Charles, hey, listen, you're free. You can go wherever you want to go. Do whatever you want to do. What would you do?
I'd probably go out front on the grass and sit down.
For how long?
For right now. How long? I could put a track record on it, or I could put a computer on it.
Come on down. Come on down. Get off computers, get off tracks. If you got out of here, there are a lot of people who think you'd go start killing people again.
Again?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you guys are misinformed. I haven't killed anyone.
What about Shay?
What about him?
Well, what about him?
He got killed.
Well, the word is you killed him. Word is you stabbed him. What does it feel like to kill somebody?
Word is that you're an old woman. Word is, you have turkey in the sky. Word is, I don't know what word is. Somebody else tell you that. I didn't tell you
did
that.
Did you kill Shay?
Hell no.
Did you cut the human's ear off?
Hell yes.
How'd that feel when you cut his ear off?
I felt bad.
Truth is fun, though. Isn't the truth fun now when you...
Okay.
You cut his ear off. What did it feel like?
My goodness.
What did it feel like when you cut his ear off? Tell me about it. Come on.
What did it feel like?
Yeah.
Well, I had done what he said for about 20 years. I've done everything he told me to do. And I got to thinking, now, why don't this guy do something I tell him to do? And he said, no. I said, well, how comes I'm always doing what you tell me to do, but then you never do what I say do? And he said, well, blah, blah, blah. So I said, now you do what I say. And he said, no. I said, you do exactly what I say. And he said, no. I'm telling you. I'm not asking you. I'm telling you. You do exactly what I say. And he said, wow, where'd you get that? I said, I got it from my father in prison. He gave it to me. I had a little charm bracelet I used to carry it on when I was about that big.
Mm-hmm. So skip that for a second. Yeah. Why was it so important for him to do what you say? Mm-hmm. Why do you like having people do
because
what you want them to do? Why do you want to control them,
Charles? Wait a minute. No, I was asked. The dude asked me, says, you my brother? I said, yeah, I'm your brother. He said, how much are you my brother? I said, completely. See, if I'm going to explain it to you, it's not going to be that easy. So you're going to have to bear with me. So Bobby said, he was a young dude, and he said, I'm your brother. I said, okay.
Bobby?
I'm your brother. Beausoleil. Beausoleil. I just got out of prison.
Wait.
Yeah.
Let me interrupt you for a second.
Yeah, well, then we're gone with that talk.
No, because you're getting on
the... Then we'll go to another, and then you make me look crazy.
No. You can make yourself look crazy, Charles.
Okay.
I can't make you look crazy, and please believe me.
All right. I'll believe you, and I'll put it in my left-hand pocket for later.
Let me take you back to you wanting this man, Hinman.
I cut to do zero off because he was over Bobby. And Bobby was a youngster and really didn't know what the hell he was doing. And he was a kid, and he never had no man show him nothing, see? So I was telling the boy, I said, the guy, he says, you got my money. I said, go and get the money or leave him alone.
You're taking me to another story.
I'm trying to tell you the same thing, and we'll be here for 1,000 years unless you let me finish it.
No. We won't be here for that long at all if you'll just speak to this one point.
Why I cut the dude zero off, man? That's the point.
I didn't ask you that. I said, why was it important to you to make Hinman do what you wanted him to do? And if one follows your story through the times on the ranch down in Southern California, it was important for Charles Manson to be a leader, to have people follow him.
Come on, district attorney. See, you've been full of brainwash. That's a district attorney. I'm nobody's leader, and I'm nobody's follower. I got a parole officer. I got a sleeping bag and a guitar, and I'm staying at Old Blind Man's Ranch. And that's about the extent of it. All this occult, all that hocus-pocus stuff that you guys are playing, I don't know nothing about all that.
You know nothing about something called Helter Skelter. You know nothing about...
Yeah, I know about Helter Skelter. It was a song that some people sang.
And that's all it was.
And some other kids picked it up in their minds. And they said, what do you think Helter Skelter is? I said, well, I get out of the penitentiary in the 50s, and everybody's going thump, 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 and they're walking like that. I get locked back up. I get out in the penitentiary in the 65, and it's going thump, 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 thump. And I get locked up again, and I come out in the 69, it's going thump, 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 thump. I'm thinking, wow, man, wow.
Wow, what? Come on,
I was a beatnik in the 50s before the hippies came along. You know, I cut a rut down through Acapulco, and I smoked Acapulco before you knew what it was. And I lived in the tombs, and I was in the Cook County Jail in Chicago when you were playing cricket in high school, see? Like you live in another world. I live in street people's world.